So out of curiosity, we decided to run an experiment. We were curious to see whether it mattered how many starting tunnels you dug for the ants. So what we did was we got two identical setups, and we started with one starting tunnel in one and four in the other. These are our results. Hi, I'm Michael with How to Ant Farm. Let's talk about ants. So here's our first group. And if you notice, these ones have dug this new tunnel here and this tunnel here. And along the bottoms, they kind of expanded them out a little bit, but they didn't do too much besides that. Also, it's worth noting that these ants, when we added them to the farm, were not eager to get started right away. They kind of were a little bit docile and treated the holes that we had dug like it was all they needed. If you notice, for the most part, all they did was come down the already made tunnels and dig either straight up or just off to the side a little bit. It's kind of like they thought they had enough room already and they're just kind of expanding to give themselves more area to sleep. Something we noted that may be the cause of them not digging as much is that because there were four well-made tunnels to begin with, they may have registered that as being enough space for them to begin with and caused them to be less eager to expand their area. And you've noticed all the matter on top that they've displaced. That may have something to do with the other one. You can see here, with this one, we only dug one starting tunnel to begin with. And as soon as we put the ants in, they busily got to work. And they went ahead and they created this tunnel here, all along the side. These ones at the sides. Something that we thought was really neat is that the patterns that they're doing here are a lot more intricate than the previous one. This could be to do with the fact that there's a lot more open space for them to build in their own patterns, whereas the other one they had a limited structure and it was built into a certain block. What's the thing that we should note about these ants is when we put these ones into the colony, they immediately got to work and started digging, unlike the other ones. We think this could have something to do with the fact that there is a lot more room for them to expand into, giving them more leeway for intricate designs, as well as the fact that they had a little limited amount of space underground to begin with, making them more eager to expand their tunnels. So the results of our experiments are this. The one with four tunnels, while more structured, the ants were less eager to start digging, and it gave them a lot less room to expand into, causing their tunnels to become a lot less intricate. The one with one tunnel, they got busily to work right away, and they immediately started digging their own intricate patterns, and we think that it gives them a lot more room to expand. So if you prefer the more structured method, then you'd probably be better off with four starting tunnels. But for us, we prefer and recommend the one starting tunnel. So after the first day of having the ants in the hill, we came in the next morning and decided to run the camera for 3 hours and take care of a time lapse for you guys. And this is what we saw.